following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to our man Jim in Palm Harbor. Hey, what's going on, brother?
Hey, how you guys doing today?
Doing great, man. How you been?
Oh, great. I really appreciate you and Tommy. You do great job, great work, and I really appreciate it. I watch you every day.
Well, thank you so much. We appreciate you growling a problem with us out here, man. Let's go to Sylvia in Tampa. Hey, Sylvia, how you doing?
Hey, Tom. Good morning. Thank you so much for taking my call. I want to tell you thank you so much for the advice you gave me on dust yesterday. I exited when you told me, and I made a healthy profit for,
that's awesome,
for a very short period. So thank you.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Surrender and let go of the past. Whatever life takes away from you, let it go. When you surrender and let go of the past, you allow yourself to be fully alive in the moment. Letting go of the past means that you can enjoy the dream that is happening right here, right now. Yesterday's gone. Tomorrow's not here. What are you doing right now? Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 262, NASDAQ off 89, S&P's down 26, gold contract up $3.50, trading at 1301 an ounce, silver $15.75 an ounce. Light sweet crude down $1.71, $51.98 a barrel. Notes and bonds. You get the 10-year note up 3 ticks, 121.16. 30-year bond up 1 point, 1 tick rather, 145.04. King dollar down 30 ticks, 95.435. The euro is trading at 114.28 to one U.S. dollar. The yen is at 109.38. And the pound is at 131.57 to one U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Okay, so percentage-wise out here, folks, what we have when we start looking at these indices, you got the S&P right now down 0.9%. The NASDAQ is off 1.2, and the Dow's down 1. That being said, what you have happening out here is this. We take a look at the SPY, you're pulling back, you get 63 million shares out here. Well, you're coming into basically 96 as well as 115. So my take here is that you're going to get a rejection of lower price. You're going to have lighter volume. Bottom line, this market still looks to me like the lows of October 11th, the game. That low price inside the SPY, folks, is 270.36. That's how this is kind of set up. What we had done on Friday, you went higher, had expansion of volume. We did 96 million shares. That 96 million was going into the 127. Didn't make it to that number, but that's what it was going to. Now what do you got? You're pulling back today, and you get light volume pullback. NDX 100, this is where the action started this morning. And when you can see the NDX 100, it's the exact same type of setup as the S&Ps. We pushed higher on Friday with 36 million. You get 24 right now. We'll probably do about 32. That 32, though, is going into 56. So NDX also wants higher price. Now, and what's intriguing about that is this. If we go into the NDX itself, you're going to see the big downdraft out here was NVIDIA. That's down 14%. AMD's down 8%. You get Amgen down 3%. You get Intuitive Surgical down 3%. All 3%. Okay, so let's start with NVIDIA. If we take a look at NVIDIA, what you're going to see in NVIDIA is this. You get 14 million shares traded. You get this big volume. No two ways about that. You're coming into big volume on a weekly. On a weekly basis, you had 31 million. So what we did out here already today is 14. So what you're going to get with NVIDIA is this. Now, what NVIDIA hasn't done is that it hasn't broken its swing low from the week of the 28th of December, which is 124. So it looks to me what we're going to have is this. You're going to get a small bounce in NVIDIA. It's going to come back down. You're going to get a retest of this low out here today. Because what is holding up NVIDIA is when you go back on the other side from May of 2017, you're going to see a monster. This is where NVIDIA broke topside and never looked back. The week of October 12th, that low there was 102. The high was 130, and you did 38 million. That's going to be a benchmark, folks. So we're going to learn quite a bit at the end of the week here about NVIDIA holding or not holding. If you hold that level, that's saying that NVIDIA is going to basically do one heck of a bounce once again. You know, you got to remember something. NVIDIA has been on a straight move down from $292. I mean, it's vicious. It's intriguing. The whole thing's really intriguing because of the fact that chips bring the NDX 100 up. They bring them down. They bring the composite up. They bring the composite down. There's no doubt that chips lead the NDX 100 as well as the composite. Dow Industrials, the strength versus the weakness inside the Dow Industrials out here today. We're down $250. And what you have Caterpillar is the leader on the way down. That's putting 83 negative points. You get Visa putting 21, 3M putting 20. Right now, the only equities that are positive at all is at IBM, JP Morgan, Johnson & Johnson, and DuPont. Small caps. We're going to take a look at the small caps out here. Excuse me, folks. The IWM. And you can see the IWM, you're down with 7. The IWM is actually almost a sideways move out here today. You're down 89 cents. 17 million shares going into 27. Not enough to break down. Gold contract. What do we have with gold? Okay, so gold contract out here today, we got 230,000 contracts. You're at 301. We did, I think, 307 on Friday. 304 on Friday. We did 304 on Friday. It's going into 316. Bottom line, gold looks to me like 345 is your next number. Now, we're going to be fighting about this number right here, this $1,300 number. We hit the 1300 on the 4th of January. Then it gave it up and went down to 275. We hit 13 onto the close on Friday. Right now, we've been oscillating around this 1300 all day long. If we go take a look at the silver contract out here, what we have with silver. Silver right now is up 0.3%. And what you have inside the silver contract is that you had good contract volume on Friday. You get some follow through out here today. Friday, we end up doing 80,000. Today, doing 55,000. And I suspect we're going to go for this 1595. Right now, you're 1575. And what that's going to be all about, folks, it's all about the good old U.S. dollar. And it's not so much about the dollar getting sold down as it is about the euro and the pound going higher. The dollar gave it up on price, gave it up on volume last Friday. That being said, you can see this is like a rerun. And this number, the 95.830, has been a rerun since October 24th. That's where the fight's coming. That's where the fight's been. And you can see what's going on here today is that, you know, we're down. But guess what? We're down 11,000 contracts, man. You need a lot more contract volume than that. This thing's going to pop right back over this 95.830 mark. We have the Dow Industrials right now trading down 225. Nasdaq is off 81. S&P's down 22. Stay right there, folks. Got our man, Mr. Steve Rhodes, coming back with us.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics, including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere, hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live, and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. We have the Dow Industrials down 247, NASDAQ off 86, S&P's off 24. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Steve Rhodes, as we do each and every Monday at 20 past the hour. Don't forget, folks, Steve's got a great program right here at TFNN. Every trading day, 12 to 1 Eastern, 1 to 2 Eastern Standard Time. Also, is a great newsletter, Mastering Probability. Now, as you come over to our website at TFNN, you're going to see right under featured content, Mastering Probability. Well, we have a special going on. We're celebrating Steve being for the year of the S&P. Bottom line, he's got the bonds, he's got the gold, he's got everything. The way this works, folks, it's a 14-day free trial for his newsletter. Now, as you come over, what you're going to be able to do is you hit that subscribe button. You can get this for a month at $149, 6 months at $695, which is a 22% off, or a year at $1,195, which is 33% off. All of those subscriptions come with the 14-day free trial. So check it out on the front page of TFNN. Let's get our man Steve Rhodes and see what's going on. What's happening, brother?
Hey, the only thing that I'd add to that so that folks know is that we have, as part of the celebration, we've gone ahead and opened this up to every listener out there. Anyone who's ever even tried Mastering Probability can come on over. There's no, you know, our normal program, as you know, is a 30-day money-back guarantee. So folks are charged at the time that they sign up. In this case here, there's no charge. There's no nothing for the next 14 days. So anyone can go ahead and sign up. And that way, maybe, you know, there's some folks that might have tried Mastering Probability 4 years ago. Well, sure. I've done a lot in the last 4 years or even the last year out there. So it's a great opportunity. It is a limited time offer. And so I just throw that out there for folks.
And then they're also getting the two webinars. Well, they get a lot. Once you get the newsletter, folks, but right on the front page, you just did that webinar, the Mastering the TD Setup. They get that with the two, right?
They do, absolutely. So there's always, you know, I think maybe there's so many different cool things that you have developed here. I don't know if cool is maybe the best adjective, but I think that it is. And you take a look at the community that you have developed here and how it is that TFNN is so differentiated from just anything else that's out there in from the standpoint of just the education. You know, we're not about, certainly Mastering Probability is not, no one here at TFNN is about just telling you what to do and that's it. We tell you the reasons why.
Right.
And really teach you the reasons why. I mean, I think I am one of the best examples for folks out there, because if I've done it, anyone can do it. I'm not anything special.
Well, you work beyond belief, too. There's no doubt. But listen, I get the gist of it. Folks, you know what's so cool? It really is. So, and I appreciate all the help we've had from the staff, all our radio hosts, of course. But when you actually do look at it, and you had brought this up before, you know, when you take these market timers, between Steve, myself, then we get Larry, then we get all the guys that Larry has on. I mean, it's and Basil and Dave. Oh. I mean, it's pretty wild, man. It really is.
It is, which is so great about the fact that you can learn to time the markets. Look, you don't have to get every. You're not gonna look. I as market time of the year, I didn't get everything correct. You know, but still outperformed the S&P and by a long shot. During a 12-month cycle, 6 months, you know, and what's really nice is I love opening up the folks' Timer Digest on a bi-weekly basis. They send out these updates, and what's so cool is that you've got me and you right in there, right, in the mix, right? So it's a beautiful thing.
We get 20% of the market, folks.
but the reality is that. Yes, I did put a lot into it. You know, I immersed myself into it. But so many of our listeners out there just look like yourself. You're the leader here. You know, you immersed yourself into market timing and understanding what the markets are communicating to us. And then, as you just said, you've brought in all of these other individuals. You know, we're all attracted to that. And so the great thing about the newsletter offer, and certainly for the next 14 days, and whether you've tried this, whether the newsletter is for you or not, everybody wants to learn something.
Sure.
And I promise that if folks just take the time, come over to the TFNN website, sign up, even if it's just for the next 13 days, you'll learn something that you'll be able to use for your own trading and investing. Maybe it's for folks that are not, you know, should I spend the time to learn technical analysis? What do I, if you're sitting on the fence, it's a great opportunity to come over there and learn something. And many of the tools that I teach, I think, are relatively easy for folks to go ahead and pick up on. And what's so great is that, and the beauty of doing the radio show, as you know, you're live, right? You're live, the market's going on right now. You're sitting there anticipating what buyers and sellers are communicating to us. The patterns that I use, that you use, work on any time frame out here. And so just as an example, I don't have anything really, you know, a lot of times when we want to do this segment, I like to have something that's prepared, but I don't have anything prepared today because really it was about talking about the benefit of the free trial offer that we have out here. But to show some folks some patterns, one of the patterns that I developed, Tom, I call the Rhodes Momentum Indicator Signals. And I developed this pattern, believe it or not. So as I had learned your system and then Gartley systems, ABCDs, all those types of things, I was looking for even more of an edge. And by looking for more of an edge, this is when I was over there full-time with you in Clearwater.
Yes.
I went ahead and took the ephemeris. Now, an ephemeris tells you where all of the different planetary alignments are per day.
Right.
And what I did was I got in touch with the producer of that material, and they went ahead and digitized it. They already had a digital version of it, but I purchased a digital version of 300 years worth of data. And then I developed a program on one of these software applications, hired a programmer to go out there to be able to look at all of the different market tops and bottoms to see if I could find an edge, something that was present at each of those tops and bottoms. And after all that time and energy, I came away saying there wasn't something that was always there before tops and bottoms. But while I was doing that, I had some other tools that were up on my screen. And so it's funny because sometimes we're looking for one thing.
Yes.
When there's something else that's really even better that's right in front of us. And you're kind of the inspiration
of that. That's pretty cool, man. Yeah.
You know, you're like, hey, you know, it's all about being present.
Right.
Because if I wasn't present, with regard to what I was looking for, I would not have been able to have identified a pattern that has been present before. Every single bear market or market where you're going to see some type of return or some type of, when I say return, some type of top or bottom. Take, for example, this 30-minute chart here for the ES Mini. As it was making its low at 12:30 this afternoon, I mean, those folks that have taken my courses out here, it makes that low. You start to see this signal with price moving lower with less relative energy and then a bullish reversal signal. And that is the pattern out there, and I teach this to folks. Now, what people can look at just in the next 10 seconds out here is price is trading right into resistance, which is the top of its 30-minute profile.
Yeah.
If price closes above 26.40, we're going right up here to this dashed green line of 26.53. So that's what folks can look at overnight. And, Tom, look, I just want to thank you for always giving me the opportunity to share with folks what I've been able to develop
Absolutely.
Out here.
Absolutely. And, folks, yeah. How you like that? Live 26.40. That's where we're at right now. Get over to our website at TFNN. You can see right under featured content, Mastering Probability. Check it out. Steve, you have a great one, safe one. Look forward to the show tomorrow.
Thanks.
Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. And don't forget, folks, to get Steve's newsletter, this special 14-day free trial, just come over to our website at TFNN. You can see right under featured content, Mastering Probability. You can hit subscribe. You can get it for a month, 6 months, a year. Either way, your card will not kick in until after 14 days. And bottom line is that it won't kick in at all if you just cancel it. Okay, so market-wise out here, you know, you get a market that went to lower price, has light volume. That's saying that, guess what, this thing is not done going up just yet. What we're going to have out here, if we take a look at some of the higher volume equities today, and this is going to be a low volume market out here today, you get Advanced Micro down $1.75. NVIDIA is the big one. That's down $22. You got Microsoft down $2. You get Verizon Communications off $1.34. Caterpillar is down 12. So let's go over to CAT and take a look at CAT. So CAT got hit out here. You know, this is a commodity stock, period. Bottom line is that CAT's down off a high of $159 3 months ago. We put this on a weekly, and what you're going to see is that, you know, from 173, that was the high that was generated in the January of 2018. Now, that being said, bottom line is that, yeah, we got a high volume low that's laying out here. I suspect it's going to get tested. But other than that, it doesn't look to me like you're going to get too much more destruction out of this. The reason being is that, you know, last week you're at 136, you're at 124. Well, you're coming into 71 million shares and 44 million. The 71 million shares, we're doing 15 today, but I suspect by the end of the week that's going to calm down. So that's the testing procedure that's happening right now when we do look at the Caterpillar. If we go into the note and bond market, this is another indication that this market still wants to bounce, and this is what it is. We have the 10-year note today up 2 ticks. That 2 ticks, not bad, right? The volume, however, folks, is that you're going up on 1.2 million contracts. That means they're still building cars here. You know, and I suspect, you know, the bottom of this cars building is 121.02. The top is basically 121.27. Because this is pushing higher today, and that volume is not big enough. And when you get a day that you're down like this, and you don't get volume inside the bond market, that is also telling me that, guess what, a bounce is coming right along. And whether you trade bonds or not, you really should start wrapping your head around them. The reason being is because they do give so much information on a continual basis. So what I do is this. You take a look at, okay, what the market is doing in general, and then I take a look at the bonds after that fact, USH9, to see is there harmony in that correlation as to what my speculation is as to where this market is going. And in this particular case, the speculation would be saying that we are still going to get a bounce, because when these bonds go higher and the market's down, they will go higher with conviction. And you can see on the 30-year bond is flat out here today. You're at 145.02. You've done 216,000 contracts. That's light contract volume. You already went to a higher price. It rejected a higher price. That's saying that the bond market's still in a consolidation. I suspect the 30-year is going to go down to 144, and you're at 145.02. So turnaround Tuesday is probably coming tomorrow. That's how this seems to be setting up. What we do have is that this week, 25% of the S&P 500 is reporting. We're going to have Facebook on the 30th. I think Apple's actually tomorrow. So Apple's tomorrow. Apple's tomorrow at 4:30. Apple's trading 155.96. And we'll see where this baby shakes out, man. Apple's going to say quite a bit. Bottom line is that Apple has been on a one-way route on the way downtown also. When you take a look at Apple, we pull this back. Apple topped out October of 2018 at 233. And what Apple, bottom line, is kind of bouncing along this area from 150 to 160. And we've been there for 7 weeks right now. You know, what has saved Apple, I believe, is the downdraft. Yeah, it's the downdraft. Oh, this is cool. It's the downdraft that we have been looking at forever. And then, of course, it finally came down and hit it. It was the high volume February week of the 9th downdraft. In Apple's case, that was 317 million shares. And then we went down there at 287. And the longer that this stays over 150, the higher the probability is that then you'll get a bounce out of this. Because that was the number at the bottom of that. It was 150.24. And it saved it the first time. You know, we'll see whether it can actually save it again. Here, I'll show you something with NVIDIA, too. This is pretty cool, folks, with NVIDIA. So NVIDIA, what's saving NVIDIA has already saved it once. And you're going to see, I mean, this has been a vicious downdraft in NVIDIA. But what you're going to see, what's saving it, if that's the right term, is in May of 2017, the week of May 12th, NVIDIA went from $102 to $130. We did 156 million shares there. Well, what had happened is that we went straight down from $292 to down to $133. The first time that we hit that for that test, we hit it with 120 million versus 156. Bottom line, you got to bounce from 133 up to 174. We come right back down, and you're going to see how clean this was. You tested with 60 million versus 120 versus the 156. That's what's holding it up. And what's so cool here, folks, is this. So NVIDIA's getting hit. They missed their numbers. They came out with a warning, and the warning is huge, folks, okay? They're going to miss their revenue number by $500 million. So you're not talking cheap money here. We're talking big money. That being said, you can see what's happening with NVIDIA. NVIDIA gaps lower, has a pickup with volume, but yet doesn't break the low swing point. That's like, really? You can't get it down there and break it? That is saying that you get buyers that are there right now. I wouldn't step into NVIDIA right now, okay? Because I suspect what we're going to see here is that you're going to see an additional test. More than likely, we're going to see if that, you know, my take is that this market wants to bounce tomorrow or the next day. We'll get a bounce. Then what normally would happen is this. You get back down into this area again, into that bar. You get another test of that bar, and the next test of that bar would be dramatically lighter. You get that, then I think you get some action on a nice counter trend bounce. You know, because the numbers actually are so dramatic, it's unbelievable, actually. Because when you take a look at this, they definitely, you know, make money basically hand over fist. That being said, you can make money hand over fist, but when you miss by 500 million and a quarter, it's pretty intense. So their quote, and they, in the Bloomberg, they put it, yeah, this is correct, because this is so, like, outlandish, that their estimate revenue had been 2.70 billion, and they said, no, we're going to do 2.2 billion. Big numbers. That's 90 days, folks. 877-927-6648. We have the Dow Industrials down 237. NASDAQ's off 83. S&P's down 23. Come right back.
Hi, folks. This is Tom O'Brien. If you'd like to be the bank and get the type of interest they receive, instead of the low interest rates they give to clients, then I have an investment you may want to take a look at. I'm offering 4-year secured first mortgages on buildable city lots in St. Petersburg, Florida. The investment can be anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000 per buildable city lot. The interest paid is 7% per year, paid monthly. Depending on the investment, the income per month per lot ranged from $175 for a $30,000 investment to $437.50 for a $75,000 investment. If you are in the CD market, you want to look at this investment. St. Petersburg is located in Pinellas County, which is the densest county in Florida. If you're looking for an investment with your principal intact that pays a good interest rate, this may be for you. The supply is limited, so act now. For more information on these secured first mortgage opportunities, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrial's down 242. You get the NASDAQ off 83. S&P's down 24. And let's go over to natural gas, folks. This is pretty wild. I mean, the natural gas market, volatility in spades, it always does continue. The thing that's actually amazing in this market is that you're at $2.90. Now, that's down from November 14th at $4.80. That being said, what is also happening here is that we have a cold front coming in that right from the Arctic that is actually going to break records in Chicago, like in a huge way. They're talking about temperatures in Chicago this coming Wednesday, a minus 25 degrees Fahrenheit. Yeah, you heard that correct, folks. So it's pretty amazing. And this isn't the first time that I brought this up about, you know, I remember whether it's last winter or winter before, I was like, you know what? You better not trade natural gas by the weather because you can see that weather report has been out here since last night, and yet natural gas opened lower today. You're trading this 290. It looks to me like if I put this on a continuous contract, it's almost like this thing is really going to do a big breakdown because, yeah, you know, this thing wants to get back down to 275, 253 is game. Yeah, that your winter spike looks like it's over, folks, and it was quite a spike. I mean, and 3 weeks you went from a price point of 310 up to 490. You know, so that's a $18,000 move in one contract. That being said, guess what? It only took 8 weeks to come right back down, and of course now what we're looking at is that you're going into February, and guess what? So you get 8 more weeks of really cold weather. At the most, that's where this is going to go. So it's going to get intriguing here. Let's get over to the oil market. So this is going to be kind of interesting to see how this one shakes out. So it looks like that the Treasury Department just basically slapped sanctions on Citgo U.S. assets to continue. U.S. can't benefit. Yeah, so what they're going to try to do is keep the Citgo assets away from the dictator in Venezuela. So they're going after the state-owned oil company, and that in turn is going to basically, that's, okay, so let's see what they say. U.S. is holding accountable those responsible for Venezuela's tragic decline. Treasury Secretary Mnuchin told reporters at the White House. This has happened in the last half hour, folks. Mnuchin said that Citgo Petroleum, a Houston-based unit of PDVSA, will be able to continue to operate but won't be allowed to remit money to the Maduro regime. Its proceeds must instead be held in blocked U.S. accounts. Can you imagine? So first they blocked the Venezuela's gold. And now this guy's going. I think he's going to go. We'll see what happens. But bottom line is that this is going to get pretty wild. Now, what's going to get intriguing here is that, let me pull up the gasoline market, because what you do have, okay, the Treasury added that that in the short term, he expects modest impact on U.S. refineries. He noted that sanctions won't affect oil already purchased that is being shipped. This is going to, now, U.S. Senator Marco Rubio praised the sanctions statement released before they were announced. Okay, so let's go look at the gasoline market. This is going to definitely affect the West Coast of the United States, that's for sure. So you got gasoline down 5.5 pennies out here. You get 22,000 contracts. Yeah, it's still going into 87,000. It doesn't look like gasoline wants to go up, you know. So you're going lower, but you have lighter volume. So it still hasn't caught a bid yet, but it doesn't look like, it actually doesn't look like it wants to go lower either. That's how this is shaking out. So we're down on 22,000, but yet you're coming into 87,000. Let's go into the oil market, the barrel oil market. We look at that. So you get crude down 2.8%. Yeah, this is the same deal. Come on, give me those volumes. Okay, so, yeah. Oil's down 151. You're coming into 951,000. You get 621. But in both cases, I want to look at Exxon. In both cases, it looks to me, folks, that the oil market and the gasoline market want higher price. This is going to be kind of a wild day out here. You can expect some traction out here. Yeah, if I look at ExxonMobil, and Exxon is, folks, is, you know, of course, one of the largest oil stocks there are, but it's been one of the weakest ones also. But even Exxon, what Exxon is doing out here today, I think it rejected $70.89. It did. And you're gonna have almost around the same amount of volume. Chevron, let's go look at Chevron. Yeah, Chevron's pullback with lighter volume. I suspect we're gonna see that oil market pick up a few pennies. You'll have the gasoline market go higher. Oil market wants higher price. Let me just pull up the USO for a second. Yeah, USO hit low today of 1078. You're trading 1096. You did 23 million shares. You're coming back into 40 million, 32 million. Yeah, it's going to want higher price. It only makes sense, too, because I think the next move will be out here is that, okay, do they, does Citgo just basically keep going? You know, if they say they're going to tie up the funds, well, then how's everyone going to get paid that is working for Citgo? They'll have to figure that out. That whole operation just may shut down. Something else that we're going to be seeing happen out here this week is PG&E. Okay, so this company here, bottom line, we'll find out whether they are going to basically file for Chapter 11. The monster California utility. It's down from a price point of 49. Hit a low out here of $5, and right now you're at $11.99. You get a million different, you get a lot of different stories out here saying that there are large large funds that are trying to get in the middle of this before they file for Chapter 11. The filing on Chapter 11 is supposed to be done, I believe, this week. So you got, let's see, billionaires and private investment firms are lining up with competing proposals to keep PG&E from filing bankruptcy in the aftermath of California's deadly fires. A consortium, including Paul Singer's Elliott Management, sent a proposal on Monday backed by $4 billion of bonds that could convert into shares of PG&E. One person with knowledge of the matter said the bonds will mature in 5 years. At least one other group, that includes Ken Griffin, Citadel, and Leon Bax, Apollo Global Management, is pitching a rival plan. The proposals were spurred after the California utility the court ruled that it was not responsible for the 2017 fire. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials down 254, NASDAQ off 90, S&P's down 25. And gold out here, folks, gold's going to hold its highs coming into this close, as the dollar's going to hold its low. So it's going to be kind of intriguing. The longer this stays up at the top of the range, meaning 13, 1303, higher the probability that we're going to get to 1345 pretty quickly. If we go up and we take a look at the opposite correlation of that, of course, that's the U.S. dollar, bottom line. It has low volume. We need more volume on the way down. That's a fact. If we get another 11,000 tomorrow, I'm not going to be digging it. 11,000 is really light volume in a huge way. The number to keep your eye on still, though, is at 95,830 mark. And right now, you're at 95,425. And if we go take a look at the British pound, and this is what's moving the dollar. You know, the British pound, this thing's really strong, man. The British pound wants to get up to this 132.95. Right now, today we hit 131.96. And, you know, if we take that baby out, I mean, bottom line, then you get game all the way up to 143. The euro start moving on Friday. You continued higher today. The euro right now wants to go to the top of this consolidation, and the top of the consolidation is approximately 114.86. Right now you're at 114.28. Now, if the euro catches a bid once again, then you get some big action, because what we'll have there is that the euro is 60% of the dollar index. That'll put some real juice inside the index itself on the way down. And we'll see whether this euro, 115 is a big number, because if we get inside 115, then you have game all the way up to 118. And that doesn't sound like a lot, but 4 pennies inside that euro, folks, will bring that dollar index down to about 92. And we haven't been there in a long period of time. And, of course, if you happen to be in the metals market, you're going to want to see that with conviction, which is wide price spread, accelerated volume. Dow Industrial's down 240, NASDAQ off 85, S&P's down 23. What you're going to have out here today, folks, you got a market that went south, you get light volume, this market still wants higher price. Stay right there, folks, we'll be coming back with lots of numbers after the close here.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get the competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This is TFNN, the Tiger Financial News Network. TFNN, headline news update. Here's Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back. Welcome, folks. We have the Dow Industrials trade down 209, NASDAQ down 79, S&P's off 21. And bottom line, folks, is that, you pull back. Bottom line, you get light volume. This market still wants higher price. We take a look at the Dow Industrials. The Dow hit a low out here today of 24,323. Well, bottom line is that you brought back 200 points. You're down over 400. Right now, you're down 209. And when you take a look at this, what you're going to see is that you didn't break a swing. You went back against the, We went back against the strength of last week. And what we did out here, volume-wise, you're lucky if you're going to do a billion shares. And right now, you know, you're going into the 22nd, which we did 1.02 billion. You know, NDX 100, same type of setup. And, you know, of course, the NDX was getting smoked with the chip stocks. That being said, you rejected lower price. You know, we got to a low of 66.44. You know, you went $57 off of that. We're down 90. There's no doubt about that. But you're going to see, if we take a look at the three Qs, what you have inside of that. Three Qs, you did 31 million shares. Well, you're coming into 56 million shares. At 160.76. We hit 161.75, rejected that number. That's telling me that, number one, you're going to go topside once again, and more than likely we're going to be seeing out here is that the NDX 100, as well as the S&P, they want to go for the low of October 11th. Inside the NDX 100, that number is 167. And if we take a look at the SPY and take a look at that number, I believe that number is 270, I think. We're at 263. Yeah, it's 270. And that's quite a way from where we are. Small caps. We take a look at the small caps out here. IWM, same. Well, you can see the IWM has already rejected it. We did 21 million shares. IWM looks to me like you're going to be dealing with 153. Yeah, 153 is game. Now, the small caps are still the weakest indice out there. That's how that the baby is shaking out. Gold contract. Don't be surprised when you wake up and gold's up $20-$30, folks. Bottom line is that you're up $5 right now. You're at the top of the range. Gold wants us 345. And the way we're trading out here, you can get that in about a heartbeat because the dollar continues to get the lower price. Recap out here, we had the Dow Industrials down 209, NASDAQ down 79, S&P's off 21. We're going to be coming back with lots of numbers after the close, folks. So 25% of all the S&P companies are reporting this week.
TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Hi, folks. This is Tom O'Brien. If you'd like to be the bank and get the type of interest they receive instead of the low interest rates they give to clients, then I have an investment you may want to take a look at. I'm offering 4-year secured first mortgages on buildable city lots in St. Petersburg, Florida. The investment can be anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000 per buildable city lot. The interest paid is 7% per year, paid monthly. Depending on the investment, the income per month per lot ranged from $175 for a $30,000 investment to $437.50 for a $75,000 investment. If you are in the CD market, you want to look at this investment. St. Petersburg is located in Pinellas County, which is the densest county in Florida. If you're looking for an investment with your principal intact that pays a good interest rate, this may be for you. The supply is limited, so act now.
For more information on these secured first mortgage opportunities, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Oh, look who we have.
It's a beautiful day. Look at our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We are taken by storm.
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But
yeah.
Holy, I mean, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. It's Super Bowl week, folks, and Super Bowl week of earnings in the marketplace, too. We have 25% of the S&P companies reporting this week. Be impeccable with your word. Release the need to be right. When you believe something, you assume you're right. You may even destroy relationships in order to defend your position. Let go of the need to defend your position. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We had the Dow Industrials down 208. NASDAQ off 79. S&P's down 22. Percentage-wise, folks, what you have out here, you have 1% in the NASDAQ. 1% in the S&P and 0.8% in the Dow Industrials. That being said, bottom line is that you have all of them basically rejecting a lower price. They all gained about 50% back of what they had done on the downdraft. And what I expect you're going to see out here is that this market still wants higher price. If we take a look at the Dow Industrials first, what you're going to see is that you were down over 400 points. We're only down 208. The Dow only did, folks, right now I'm at 860. So you had 860 million going against the 1.023 billion on the 22nd. That's not a market that basically wants to give it up just yet. What I expect we're going to see here, what we had on Friday is this. You had an expansion of volume on Friday as you try to take out the swing high. Well, the Dow Industrials actually did take out its swing high. Bottom line, now today out here, you're back down, you had lighter volume. Bottom line, still wants higher price. I expect the Dow is actually going to try to run also to the lows of October 11th, which are 24,899. So you're talking about another 400 points higher before this thing wants to get into lower price. If we go take a look at the SPY, the SPY, what you're going to see, the SPY did 80 million shares out here today. That's light volume in a big way. What you did do is that you rejected the lower price at 261. That was going into 115 million, you did 80. That's also setting up higher price. And the SPY, I suspect we're gonna run somewhere to 270. NDX 100, same type of setup. And what's gonna happen with the NDX, folks, is this, is that you have the aspect of the NDX All the big NDX stocks, they're going to be starting out tomorrow. Apple's going to basically be kicking these babies off. The Qs today, they came down with 31 million shares, going into 56 million. You're trading 163.11. This thing looks to me like it wants to go up to this 167. Gold contract wants higher price. Bottom line is that you don't have any sellers in the gold market. You get buyers. This thing was up $5 today. 234,000 contracts. You basically closed over all the highs. So if we take a look at this on a continuous contract, what you're going to see inside the gold market is that we put this back a couple weeks, and you're going to see it's real possible that this is just a monster ABC structure on the way up. When you go back to the week of November 16th, gold was trading at 1196. It was a straight line move right up to 13. You had 4 weeks of going sideways with volume. I suspect the next straight line move is going to bring you to 1365. 1365 was our high out there in April. And, the dollar is set up just the opposite. If we take a look at the dollar index, what we're going to need, this is what the differential is right now. The dollar index needs more volume on the way down. The dollar index has been fighting over this 95.830 mark since October 24th. Bottom line, once it gets inside that level, it seems that every single time it basically pops right back outside it again because there's not enough volume on the way down. That happened again today. So we'll see if that can stay down, and we have some follow through tomorrow. My take right now is that your next leg down will be about 94,600. The bigger position here, if we get volume, is going to be down to this 93.92, which brings you back to September of 2018. And then if you really take a look at this, if we actually do have a major change of trend inside the marketplace, you'll be down to 88. And it looks to me that we actually do have a major change of trend. And what that change of trend is this, folks, is that the euro has been coming down. Oh, hey, let's do the pound first. So you got to remember, it was 3 years ago that the citizens of the UK voted to the UK voted to get out of the European Union. Bottom line, that's when it was. The pound was trading at a price point of 150 when this Brexit was coming up. Prior to that, a year prior to that, it was at 171. So we've gone straight down from 171 in July of 2014 when they start worried about they're going to get out. Then they voted it out. It went from 150 to 130, went all the way down to 118. Talk about losing wealth over the course of months. That's a monster amount of wealth. That being said, what you have is that the low was established in October of 2016. Your next low is established this month, bottom line, and it looks to me like now this pound wants to get to 143. And we'll see what they're going to do about Brexit. The euro is the same type of setup, meaning it's at the lower end of the range that it has been for quite some time, because their bottom line is that there's chaos over there. We've come down from 125 and February of 2018, you bounce it along this bottom of 117. It looks to me like 115 is going to be the big number in the euro. If the euro can get inside of the 115, bottom line, then you got action up to this 118, and then it's really actually game up to 122. And if that's what you get with both of those going higher, the dollar basically will not only be lower, the dollar will be substantially lower. Now, the last part of this inside the currency market for the gold would be the yen. When the yen gets stronger, gold loves the yen getting stronger. Bottom line, with the yen out here, we're at 109.38, and that's going to need some juice to get back inside the 108.98. But what we do have is that we have a high volume spike at 104. That's when the good old yen crashed, when one market was opening, another market was closing. But that's a real trade, folks. That actually went down into those levels. Dow Industrials right now finished down 208. NASDAQ off 79. S&P's off 23. 21, rather. Stay right there. Come right back.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go take a look at some of the higher volume equities out here. So this is a low volume market. It rejected lower price. I expect what you're going to see out here, folks, is that this market still wants higher price. Some of the highest volume equities out here today is that the Advanced Micro is down $1.75. NVIDIA, which kicked this baby off, down $22. NVIDIA came out with a warning that they are going to basically make a lot less revenue. The revenue, the warning they came out with was pretty extensive, folks. They planned on making $500 million less in one quarter. Okay, so you're talking about a big number. They were expecting to take in $2.5 billion and gross revenue, they're looking at $2 billion now. So it's going to be a big number. You get Pfizer's down $1.11. We got Microsoft off $2.09. Caterpillar was another big one. Caterpillar come out with numbers. Caterpillar traded down, I believe, $11. Let me pull this baby up. Caterpillar, see where you ended up. $12.49. So it's down $12.49. If we go over and we take a look at Caterpillar, you're going to see that this has been a consolidation on the way down. Caterpillar had a high of 173 in January of 2018. It's got a high volume low that's sticking out like a sore thumb, 112. 112 is definitely game now. Because what you had here is this, the top of that bar was 133. And you can see you already got $10 into that bar. Your probability gets much higher that you get down there. Now, that being said, I think it's really going to be hard to break down Caterpillar at that level. The reason I'm saying that is that Caterpillar I certainly could have got down to the 116 today, but yet it didn't have enough juice to get down there. And when that happens, when you actually see volume come out of an equity before it gets to a swing point, your probability gets much higher that as you get to that swing point, what ends up happening is that the volume dies in the vine, it rejects lower price, and then you get a consolidation in place. And that'll be pretty cool with Caterpillar, because what you do have is that the top of the consolidation that Caterpillar is actually in is 136. So if you're down in there at the 112 and you do get a rejection of lower price, well, then you have game on in a big way. That's how this baby is set up at this particular point. Let's go over and take a look at some of these cannabis stocks. These things have taken off again, no doubt. These are going to be, I suspect, they're going to continue to be volatile. Now, Canopy, which is the one of the largest cannabis stocks out there, their revenue model goes like this. They're going to be looking, now this is what's going to get really intriguing here. This is the quarter that they're going to go from $23 million that they're still expecting to do $84 million. So they're saying in 90 days, they have gone from $23 million up to $84 million. So we'll see where this shakes out, because the bottom line is that that's quite a feat, if in fact they can pull that off. The low is $16.73 for the year. The high is $59. You're trading at $50.77. And what we did do is that you got volume out here on Friday. You know, it's actually a small ABC up. Well, it's a close call. Actually, isn't an ABC up, but this has a high volume high of 59. So I expect that's going to get hit. That being said, that number is coming out, let's see, February 14th. That's when that is coming out. If we go take a look at Cron. Let's see, C-R-O-N. Our man Jim from Minneapolis turned us on to this one. This is quite a run, too. This is Cronus Group. This company here, revenue-wise, they basically are looking to go from $3.8 million to $8.8 million. And they're not coming out, though, until April. And this thing went topside in a big way out here today. It was up $2.46. I see. Oh, boy, this is going to be a trip. I just bring up the news on this, and evidently, let's see what this says. Let's see. The cannabis producer Cronus is going bananas after Mad Money host Jim Cramer called the second best in the industry. So Cramer must have been... Cramer, this is a Friday night show, I guess. Cramer is basically pumping that in there on Friday night, and bottom line is that it got juice out there today. The thing is, it is amazing, looking at a few of these, this is a $3.3 billion with a B market cap. They only have 7 employees. my God, let me pull this up for a second. Let me just see who the biggest owners of this is. Well, there's no one that's really big. You get 5% here. There must be, let me see. Let's see the CEO, what they own. Look at that. He doesn't own much. You know, it's so weird, man. I can't quite understand it when, you know, you get a company that's, if you think it's going to do good, how do you own only 0.7% of it? But bottom line, that's what the CEO owns. Let me see what the board owns if I pull this back just a bit. If I go into management first. The top dog, that's all he owns. It's not a lot. That's not a lot. There's no two ways about that. That is not a big number. I'd like to see a lot bigger numbers than that. Particularly when you're talking about something that's so brand new, okay? It's not a big number. Apple. So Apple is going to be tomorrow, folks. They come out with, I believe it's 4:30. Yeah, 4:30 tomorrow. Apple's coming out with its numbers, and they're going to have to be not only coming out with their numbers, they're going to have to be coming out with, like, huge amounts of new products, something to basically keep that stock up. Let's see what the... Apple's planning a subscription service for games. Great. That's not going to give them the phones. You know, when you take a look at the... you know, Apple's not reporting their phone sales anymore, the iPhones, and that's why you can see that Apple's tanked beyond belief, because what has happened is that their suppliers have gone down, China's gone down, bottle on, you only can hide it for so long. But when you actually take a look at the numbers, their growth numbers, you can see iPhones, folks, that is, for the last 3 years, 2% a year. That's all that's been growing. I suspect if they actually come out with the numbers, would see that on a negative. Now, what will end up happening, whether they come out with it or not, you'll have Bloomberg dig into this, and we'll get some kind of a number out of that in the next couple of days, you know, after Apple comes out with those numbers. Thus far, what you have out here, you can see that it's changed dramatically, the Apple numbers, as to where their growth prospects are. They're growing by 6% in the United States, 7% in Europe. They're contracting by 4% in China. They're growing by 11% in Japan. Services is their biggest area right now. The services are growing by 25%, but this is what the differential is. Their service business per year takes in $39 billion. Their iPhone business takes in $164 billion, and that's the one that basically is not growing and will probably go negative, you know. So Apple's, you know, bottom line, you know, in for a few more bites as it basically tries to pump up those sales. Dow Industrial's down 208, NASDAQ off 79, S&P's down 21. Come right back.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. And we were just talking about the cannabis stocks. I want to thank one of our tigers in the den. So for this heads up. Organigram, folks, bottom line is that they came out with numbers, I believe, this morning. Now, check this out, because this is impressive. There's no doubt. This equity gained 12% intraday. The New Brunswick-based company reported revenue in, this is Canadian dollars, 12.4 million Canadian dollars, which ended on November 30th, which included a month and a half of legal recreational sales. That is up 419%. The gross margin, this is pretty intense, was 71% versus 25% a year ago. Net income from continuing operations was 20%. Let's see. Yeah, okay, so here you go. Net income from operations looks like it's a positive versus they thought they were going to lose. Looks like it's a positive. I can't be. Net income from continuing operations. Something's wrong with that because they didn't even take in 29 million. They're saying it's 29.5 million, but it can't be because they didn't take in 29 million. Cash costs of cultivation was 56 cents per gram of dried flower equivalent, down from 62 cents. Inventory at the end of the quarter was 91 million Canadian, up from 49 million. Budget for phase four campus expansion has increased to 120 to 125 from 110. Now, what's intriguing about this, this symbol is OGRMF. So this is traded over the counter. That being said, the spread is still narrow, and this is an ABC structure on the way up. This took out a B point with volume. You know, so your A point on this is 297. Your B is 496, so you got $2. Your C is out here at 444. That's 644 rather. And, you know, 668, yeah, high swing. You're trading at 530. Now, it's intriguing about that. That is saying that Canopy very well could basically do that acceleration on the way up, because you can see that acceleration there. Canopy's looking to go from 23 million to 84.4. It's going to be pretty wild if that's what they do. That's an expansion. And because the quarter after that, they're looking for 119 million. And, you know, what you are going to see is that you're going to see the aspect that there's going to be more and more pressure across all these states and on the feds. Oh, if you haven't seen this yet, this is a trip, folks, okay? So sometimes, man, the hypocrisy in a lot of these deals between politicians and what's going on in the cannabis business is amazing. So you get John Boehner. If you've heard the ad about John Boehner, right? So what happened is that the folks that are behind Boehner wanted to put an ad in the Super Bowl, folks, okay? So check it out, in the Super Bowl. But let me just explain to you how big this is. So if you listen to, it doesn't matter, it's Bloomberg, CNBC, CNN, Fox, you know, every single station, you're hearing the next big thing, John Boehner, you know, you can get in on the cannabis stocks. Well, you know what this is? This is what's amazing. So they have Boehner as the head guy, basically pushing a bunch of cannabis stocks. Some of them are pump and dumps. Some of them, you know, bottom line is it's they evidently are making money hand over fist because of the fact that the cannabis summit, all it is basically is a newsletter to pump and dump equities, not the canopies of the world, not the canopies of the world, but, you know, buyer beware. That's the real bottom line. That's what you want to basically, if you check it out, just be careful. It looks like the Justice Department just put a criminal charge on the CFO of Hiwa, the woman, the daughter of the founder that's up in Canada right now. So that just happened. Department of Justice is seeking the extradition of her to the U.S. And it doesn't say, let me see if it says what it's, okay. This is pretty intense what they're saying. So check out what they're saying. So the Justice Department is saying that Hiwa offered bonuses to employees who stole IP secrets. They conspired to steal USA's, company's intellectual property, steal phone testing technology from T-Mobile. They're accusing the founder of making false statements related to Iran. Bottom line is that they get some heavy deals going on. Oh, you talk about a heavy deal, too, is that what you have with Nissan, with Goshen, the SEC, this guy, you know, it's hard to comprehend that you have so many millions, but then you want even more millions. Now, it's still an allegation, but the bottom line is that now what you have, this is the Goshen, who was the CEO of Nissan that they have in jail in Japan. Well, our SEC is also going after Nissan. They're going after him for, and ISS, let me pull this up, for the same thing. The bottom line is that here, I'll get to the story. And what this is saying is that they're saying, here it is. Nissan just said to face SEC probe on pay after Goshen's arrest. So what the SEC is saying also is that the U.S. financial regulator is examining whether Nissan's executive pay disclosures were accurate and whether the car maker had adequate controls to prevent improper payments, the people said, who asked not to be identified. The allegation, here it is, the allegation, okay, both men... Let's see. The SEC investigation has added scrutiny to surrounding Japan's second largest automaker and its executives after the Japanese authorities arrested Goshen and Greg Kelly. Both men were indicted over allegations that Goshen underreported his income at Nissan by tens of millions of dollars. The carmaker, whose largest shareholder is French alliance partner Renault, also has been indicted, a step to allow prosecutors in Japan to lay formal charges. Bottom line, it looks like this guy's in deep trouble. Because the SEC allegation is also the same disclosure that bottom line is that there was money getting paid to the SEC that wasn't disclosed, to shareholders. Pretty intense. So you got the State of the Union is going to be, it's not this week, it's going to be February 5th, folks. That's where the State of the Union is going to be coming across. We'll see where that baby shakes out. If we get over and we take a look at the bonds out here, this bond market is still saying that I suspect what you're going to get out here is you're going to get a pop in the market. It's going to be like a turnaround Tuesday. We'll see what can actually push this turnaround Tuesday. But that's how it looks like it's setting up right now. Dow Industrials closed down 208. NASDAQ off 79. S&P's down 22. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. 877-927-6648. Let's go to Dallas in Tampa, Florida. Hey, Dallas, what's going on?
This is Al in Tampa, Florida.
Al, what the heck happened, Al? I love it. So you were talking to an Al, and he thought you were Dallas. I like it. What's happening, Al? How you been, man?
Well, not that great. I lost my right foot. I got a bad infection, and they had to amputate it off. So I'm sorry, man. So I'm in rehab right now trying to get it healed and getting a prosthetic.
Wow.
But I'm fighting there.
Good.
I'm fighting in there.
Man, you've had a long road with that foot, man. Holy cow.
5 years. Yeah, 5 years I've been fighting it, and it's been winning. And finally, I feel 180% better. I'm not taking all those chemicals and stuff like that.
Okay.
Fight the antibiotics with that.
Yep.
And that was just doing a thing on my body and my sugars and everything else. So,
okay.
It might be a blessing in disguise.
Okay, good. Well, we wish you the best, man. We'll send that good white light out to you. So, did they cut it off at the ankle? Where'd they cut your foot off, man?
Well, below the ankle.
I see.
I got that little part down there.
Okay.
So, the VA is going to make another prosthetic for me. So,
okay.
They're going to make a prosthetic, but we have to wait like 3 months for it to heal and toughen up the skin before they can go ahead and do it. Plus, there's learning on how to do everything with one leg gone. And
no, I know. Well, I'm sorry to hear that, but I'm glad to hear that.
The easiest thing that you think is going in the bathroom is one of the hardest things in the world to do, but I just want to thank you for all your help and in the past and that, and I've got one stock that I've kept for too long, and I really it's coming back to where I can get out of it for what I paid for it. And COG, and I'm just wondering, it's coming up to the top, and I think it failed today.
Okay, let's take a look. So you get Cabot Oil and Gas. The low's 20, the high's 27. They're coming out with the numbers February 22nd. Okay, so you get a high volume high out here at 27.40. No, I'd stay right there, man. I think you got an ABC up. So here, this is a little tricky, but this is what the market did today, too, folks. Okay, so picture this. If we look at Cabot had a swing point on the 18th of January, $25.88. You had 7.3 million. Friday, we took that out with 7.9 million, and that's an ABC up. So your A point is like 22. Your B's 25.5, so you get $3.50. Your C's 24.75, so what? You get 27, let's just say 27.50. And yeah, your swing high there is 27.40. I think it's going to go for it, Al. I think you got, let me pull this back a little bit more, but.
Yeah, well, it's only a 26 something, so.
Well, you know what you can do? I mean, there's a couple different ways you can do this. You could put an order in and let it just lay there. Right under 27.40. So, you know, if it goes up there and tests and fails, well, guess what? You're at 27.55 or something. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Just in case you're not in front of the machine at the time. That's a way that you can do that, because it looks to me like it's going to go for it. Now, there's no doubt what stopped it last time was the downdraft out there from February of 2018. Now, what's really cool about this equity, though, is this. Okay, so picture this. When you look at the oil market in general, the oil market has been coming down for quite some time, okay? This baby here, you know, is closer to its highs than its lows. And then what we just had, you know, folks, as the market closed today, is that you had the Treasury Department, bottom line, put restrictions on the huge oil company in Venezuela, as well, and part of that is Citi, bottom of Citgo. So what's going to happen, there's going to be a little disruption here. And I suspect when I brought up, Al, not only the gasoline market, but the oil market, and both of them were down today, it looks to me like they want to bounce a little. There's going to be a little disruption here. The administration's claiming that it's not going to, there'll be disruption.
The one I chose is a little diversified, too. They're into drilling in that, too, so.
Yeah, they're evidently not just, you can see, well, independent oil and gas develop, exploits oil and gas properties in North America. Whatever they're doing something that the large integrated oils aren't doing, because this is definitely in better shape than the Exxons and Chevrons of the world. But I'd put the order in, man, but I'd stay right there, because it looks to me like that does want higher price, man.
Can I ask you about one more Lumber Liquidators?
I love it. Let's take a look. Little Lumber Liquidators.
I made some money on it, and I did lose some money on it, so I didn't lose any money. I gave a bunch of it back, and I shouldn't have.
Yeah, let's take a look. So the low's 9, the high's 30. You're trading at 11.74, because this is coming out with numbers. The 26th.
It already came up with good numbers.
Okay, 26. This is subtle, but, can it run to 12 to 13? Yeah, it can. Let me put this one second. Yeah, this is, it can run to $13, let me see what the short position is on this right now. Yeah, well, you get the short position going with you. You get 21.7% of short position, which is helpful when, the stock's only $11, because, they can run this thing. So I'd hold on to it.
Okay.
I wouldn't sell it. you know. But when it's up at that level, if that volume dies in the vine again, then move it, man, because this has been in a downtrend, you know, since September of 2017, $41 down to 11.
Yeah, I know, though. I rode part of it down, so. But I moved a bunch of it over to, and then I moved all the Apple and stuff like that, and then I get slaughtered with Apple. What are you supposed to do? So.
Well, what you got to do? See, you aren't such a streak. What happens when you're on a streak like that? You got to take some of this money off the marketplace, period. Because what I've found is that you can parlay, you know, an account like a couple times. The third time you can't parlay it. I haven't been able to anyway.
I did it. Remember with AMD?
Yep.
I caught AMD within 1 or 2 days of it. I called you on the AMD.
I remember it was so well because I'll pull it up right now, and I remember that topped out right after you called, man, $34, and that was an ABC up. It extended itself, and then it gave it up in spades. I remember that. Yep.
It went all the way back down to 18.
I know. Oh, listen, man, it's vicious. Yeah, it's like crazy, man. I know. It's wild. Well, listen, man, I'm glad, you know, that. You know, I'm sad that you lost your foot, but I think that all those drugs now, as you say, that you're not going to have to take, you're probably going to feel a lot better. And, you know, we'll send some good white light, and you'll start getting used to that new foot of yours, man.
Okay, well, thank you, Tom, very much.
Okay, Al, have a great one, man. Have a safe one. Okay. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. So we had the Dow finished down 208, NASDAQ down 79, S&P's off 23. In all cases, folks, what you had, most of the market came back up, almost 50% off its lows. If we take a look at the SPY, what you're going to see is that you went from 261.79, closed out at 263.76. You did 84 million shares. That was going into 115 million. So what that sets up, once again, is higher price. You know, this week here, folks, we have 25% of all the S&P companies that are going to be reporting. What you also have is that it is what? It's going to be window dressing the end of the week, okay? That window dressing is the last couple of days of the month, the following first and second of the next month. That is a natural upward bias inside the marketplace. What I expect you're going to see out here is this. You're going to see the SPY basically go after the last two swing points that we had. You know, we went higher on Friday with volume, 266.70. That prior Monday, we did 260, the prior Friday, because we were off Monday, was 266.98. That also had 127 million shares. That's telling me we want to get into those, more than likely go over those, and get up into 270. That being said, that's the short-term deal. That being said, guess what? When window dressing is over, folks, see ya. Don't want to be ya, because the larger take, so that's the shorter take on the marketplace. Larger take on the marketplace when you put this back is that what I expect we're going to see inside the SPY is that we're going to be running down into the price point of 221. If we take a look at the SPX, this is your benchmark out here on a longer term, folks. And longer term, all I'm talking about, I think this turn is going to start in another couple of weeks, is that we pull this back and what you're going to see, it's the November, I believe, 2014 number. Is it 2014? No, 2016. So in the cash S&P, you're talking about 2214. That's quite a way from where we are. We're at 2643. The last low out there, though, got to 2346. So when you take a look at where we were at the last low versus where I'm thinking it's going to go, it's not a big deal. It's 100 points below that. It certainly is, though, from where we are right now. Because from where we are right now, you're talking approximately 500 points lower or 5,000 Dow points. Pretty intense. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Everything you need is right inside you. You might as well have a blast with it, folks. Look forward to speaking right back here at 9 o'clock tomorrow morning.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get the competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.